Immediately after Direct Connection tonight, MPT is airing Conquering Memory Loss with Dr. Majid Fatui. Here is a preview.
More learning means more synapses. More synapses means better communication. And better communication means better brain function. This has led to the concept of reserve. And the idea is that as you grow older, you gain more synapses. And the more you're active, the more you learn, the more synapses you have. This is similar to the way you would think of collecting money, saving money. When you put money away for retirement, the more money you put away, the more money you will have, the more reserve you will have when you get to your retirement age. The same idea applies to synapses in the brain. The more synapses you have, the better would be your ability to withstand whatever happens with aging.
And joining us now in the studio is Dr. Majid Fatui, who is the director of the Memory Disorders Unit at Sinai Hospital and author of The Memory Cure, How to Protect Your Brain Against Memory Loss and Alzheimer's Disease. Dr. Fatui was good enough to bring his spare brain tonight. I could have used this earlier. I wish you brought it out. Tell me about the book and what prompted you to write this.
I think this is a really exciting time in the field of memory research and Alzheimer's disease. For the first time in decades, Alzheimer's is going to be considered a preventable disease. There are many things that you can do to prevent memory loss that comes with aging. Before, people thought you either get Alzheimer's or you don't. Now it turns out to be shades of gray, and what you do in your midlife makes a huge difference on when and to how severe would be your memory loss.
I know there's some trials going on of anti-inflammatories, of a potential vaccine. Is there a glimmer of hope in that?
So that's some of the examples that are toward the point that you can prevent memory loss. There are other things that are better established. For example, high blood pressure. If you control your blood pressure, you cut your risk of developing Alzheimer's by half. This is well established. Increased physical activity, that really makes a huge difference on how well you keep your brain. And most important, how active you are. I think your job is a good example of someone who would maintain a lot of synapses because you keep learning new things, you talk with new people, and I think these issues are very important in preserving the brain.
Well, you've just made me feel a lot better. I appreciate that. But for people who are worried about Alzheimer's, every day that you forget where you put the car keys or you forget an item on your mental shopping list, causes tremendous worry because people may have seen it in their families, and there's great concern. How does somebody know when to talk to an expert?
Okay, first of all, 90% of people who complain about memory problems don't have Alzheimer's disease. Many people worry about it unnecessarily. I have some things in my book, a list of 12 questions which you can ask and sort of go over to sort of establish if your memory loss is concerning. But one quick way to know is, if you forget something and later on somebody gives you a hint, will you remember it? For example, let's say you don't remember the name of the movie and somebody gives you a hint. If you remember it, that's a good sign.
That's a hopeful sign.
If you say what movie, that would be a bad sign.
Right. Now, the kinds of prevention techniques that you're talking about sound like long-term things, getting more physical exercise, more mental exercise, keeping your blood pressure down. It's not something you can turn to today and expect results tomorrow.
And I think that will be unreasonable to expect that as complex as your brain is to do something today and have better memory tomorrow. My book is more about preventing memory loss that comes with aging, about preventing Alzheimer's disease. If your parents have Alzheimer's and you want to cut your risk in the long run, this is what you do. It's like putting money away in a retirement plan.
I've heard that crossword puzzles are a good thing to do, and then I've also heard that crossword puzzles don't make any difference. What do you think?
Well, I think the more active your brain is, the better chance you have to stay mentally sharp later in your life. It's like exercising your muscles. The more you tone up your muscles, the stronger you will be. That really applies to the brain. And I think that's actually surprising because the brain and muscle are so different from each other. But yet it turns out that activity strengthens function.
And once Alzheimer's has been diagnosed, how do we stand in terms of being able to treat it?
Well, for the first time, we have many options. 4 years ago, we would have sorrow, say, we're really sorry you have this. But now, I have a list of medications I give my patients. There are cholinesterase inhibitors, such as Aricept and other medications. There are new drugs, which are glutamate receptor antagonists called memantine, and there's vitamin E. So when I talk with my patients, there's a list of medications to work with, and people don't get better, but the rate of decline slows down.
We have to leave it there. More with Dr. Fatui through the evening here on MPT. Thanks for talking with
us.
My pleasure. Now, as we discussed tonight, the FCC is cracking down on what they term indecent broadcasts, and that is the subject of this week's poll question. Should the FCC crack down or clamp down on broadcast indecency? You can vote online at mpt.org. Lieutenant Governor Michael Steele joins us Thursday for Business Connection. Have a good night.
Direct Connection is made by MPT to serve all of our diverse communities and is made possible by the generous support of our members. Thank you.